Okay,
will do
glad.
start. Yeah.
He is doing something.
So a very good evening to all of you. On behalf of ICSI IIP, I welcome all of you to today's webinar. The subject of this webinar is today it is e-filing procedures before NCLT, and the topic is very much a need of the hour. Right now we are on the COVID period and everybody is interested to do the capacity building thing, and then at this point only the ICSI IIP comes with this kind of topic. So today we have with us Mr. Shivram Bhairava, the registrar of NCLT Delhi. So welcome you, sir, to this webinar and to provide your expertise on this subject. And today's webinar will be moderated by Mr. G.P. Madan, the insolvency professional. So welcome to him too. So over to Mr. G.P. Madan, the moderator, to take the things forward.
Thank you, Dr. Binoy. Welcome, Mr. Bhairava. Sir, welcome to this program, and people have been waiting for this event. Actually, there was a lot of requests to the Institute IIP also that we should have a program. Rather, since the day, I think maybe for last couple of days, we have been circulating this program, and there were a number of requests from advocates also that we also want to join in. So it's a program which scheduled by ICSI IIP, but number of lawyers have also shown their interest, and I can see the number of lawyers have already joined this program. Good evening, participants. First of all, let me introduce to you Mr. Shivram Bhairava. Those who are regular visitors to NCLT Delhi, they do not, Mr. Bhairava does not need any introduction to them. Mr. Bhairava, no doubt, is the registrar of NCLT, but over and above this, I think he's a perfect human being, a thorough professional, a very helpful person, always easily accessible, very, very cooperative. You go to him, raise your problem, and you will get the reply. You will get the cooperation, you will get the coordination, you will get the solution if the solution is in his hands. Certainly the solution is not in his hands, certainly he will have his own limitations. I'm having pleasure of being one of the members in WhatsApp group here. Mr. Bhairava is also there. The moment any issue is raised in the group, I tell you within minutes, Mr. Bhairava comes out with this solution, and very, very practical solution. And I'll say, though he's with the government, but I'll say he's with us also, always with us. Mr. Bhairava, sir, today's program is on NCLT e-filing. A number of questions have already received before the event also. And I'm sure that without raising those questions, even you will be handling everything. Your presentation would be clarifying most of the issues which have been raised and most of the doubts. Some of the basic issues, sir, which have been raised are, you are sitting at a principal bench.
Yeah.
So whatever you will be discussing today, will it be for Delhi or will it be covering the entire gamut of all the benches of NCLT across the country? Number two, whether all the NCLT benches are in e-mode nowadays, whether e-filing has been initiated by all the benches across the board. Whether payment can also, e-payment is being made, is possible to be made in all the benches as on date. And in addition to this, I tell you there are a number of questions listed before me. I think better you have your presentation first. I'm sure number of these questions will be answered in your presentation. After that, if there are any question which is yet to be answered, I'll raise that question after the presentation, sir. But I'm sure we are going to have number of questions. Sir, at the end, I'll request you, even though we are surpassing the time, please try to be with us so that members can get the satisfactory answer to all their questions. Where was that?
Okay, good evening. Good evening, Madan sir. Good evening, Dr. Binoy. And good evening to all of you. Let me first give the overall of the view of the NCLT. So, you know that presently, Delhi is considered as two benches, a principal bench and New Delhi bench. And in this way, there is a 16 benches all over India. And presently located at 13 locations. So let me tell you the locations also. If you start right from the north of the country, Chandigarh, which covers the state of J&K, state of Haryana, state of Himachal Pradesh, Union Territory, and NCLT Chandigarh covers. Then NCLT Delhi, NCLT Delhi is covering the Delhi area. State and then NCLT Jaipur, it is covering NCLT Rajasthan, NCLT Allahabad, Allahabad covering Uttarakhand and state of UP. Similarly, in Northeast, NCLT Guwahati is there, all Northeast states are there, and Jharkhand, Bihar, and West Bengal is covered by the NCLT Kolkata. Then you come a bit south. NCLT Ahmedabad is covering right now and Gujarat and Daman Diu. So, and this Indore bench is also currently sitting at Ahmedabad, which will be covering, which is covering the state of Madhya Pradesh. Similarly, Cuttack is covering Orissa and Chhattisgarh. Then Mumbai is covering state of Goa and Maharashtra. Then down below, Bangalore is covering Karnataka. Telangana is covered by Amravati. And Telangana is Hyderabad and Andhra is this thing, Amravati. So what, Tamil Nadu is covered by NCLT. Chennai, Kochi, is covering the NCLT Kerala. So I think now all the participants are well aware that this is the framework of the NCLT. Now the first question Madan Sahab is whether I am talking about the NCLT Delhi only or the of the about all the NCLT. So this is to be understood that this module of the e-filing, it is for all the NCLTs, first of all. Yes, but now the second question, whether it is operative right now in all NCLT or not. So today, as on today, we are operating 6 NCLTs. Okay. So which one is 60? One first Delhi, Mumbai, Jaipur, Hyderabad, Amravati, and yesterday only we have started in Chandigarh also. So in this way, e-filing has been started in 6 NCLTs. The module is same, and other NCLTs also we have made the practical virtual presentation to the all stakeholders, litigants, to all other NCLTs also, and very soon, let it be the COVID only, but in the July itself, I'll try to cover all the NCLTs through e-filing.
Very good.
Our plan is from 1st July, Kolkata, if the Kolkata system will give me okay, then certainly Chennai is also ready. Yes, 2-3, maybe Cuttack and Guwahati may be lagging because of the infrastructure, that is the issue. Otherwise, we will try to cover all our India by July end. And certainly cooperation of the you people, all other stakeholders, advocates, chartered accountants, company secretary and other post accountants, whosoever is there, whosoever that is required. Now, issue is that what is the e-filing? See, for example, today we are doing this webinar. What is this? It is nothing but we are translating the virtual mode or the actual gathering. We all are able to communicate with each other, but we are not gathered together at one place. It is to be understood how we have translated in the key platform in the normal seminar that is now become the webinar. Similarly, the filing we have translated into the computerized computer language. So for example, I am corroborating this thing, and it is to be understood, for first of all, what we have done today, all participants, we have first of all we saw that yes, there is some webinar going on in Thailand. So let us register ourselves. Okay. So what you have done, you have registered yourself. Similarly, in e-filing also, the e-portal of the NCLT, you have to go and register yourself. You have to register yourself as an, if you are an individual, register as an individual. If you are a firm, register as a firm. If you are an advocate, register as an advocate. If you are a company secretary, do that. If you are a chartered accountant, cost accountant, or even the litigant, simply, you can register yourself in the portal of the e-filing, the NCLT. So how you register? When you file all these things, you will get the OTP, you will get the password, you will get your ID, and you are registered. So this registration, for example, this registration that you are able to see the participate in this webinar. Similarly, when you register for the e-filing of the National Company Law Tribunal, then you are able to file your all filings right from the first petition to all replies, or even as a petitioner, as a respondent, you can act as whatever the manner, but you have to register. Now, once in a beginning itself, I want to clear, because Madansa is there, and I think so many among you are insolvency professionals. So we have kept that also, that you can register insolvency professional. So that is the list is there. I show in the presentation also, but first you just presentation see. Presentation in this thing, before presentation, please listen this thing, that presentation, when I'll show the presentation, you'll be able to see and understand that what I spoke, that is this thing only. So when you register as a litigant, as a chartered accountant, as company secretary, or as a cost accountant, or in whatever manner, what you can say, it's an insolvency profession also. We have kept so many individual, first of all, individual, then advocates, chartered accountants, company secretaries, cost accountants, ROC also, they have to register themselves. ROCs also, they have to register because they have to file so many reports. In the merger cases or in the compounding or in other 252 also, we require their reports. Okay, so you all are aware who are the practicing CS, they are aware how the company secretaries are involved. And similarly, RDE also, and other officials, even your income tax department, your income tax department lawyer, they have to register. Insolvency professionals, IRP and RP, or other any government department also. Why different categories there? Because our system recognizes that. And one thing, we have to have your identification. For example, an advocate will be having that number, that bar council number. Similarly, chartered accountant or company secretary, they are also having the issues number. That identity you have to put in that. And IRP, they are also having their IRP number. Similarly, they are having. And for the government department, why they have to have the registration? Because they are filing. When we are switching over on the e-filing, then we cannot leave anybody for the physical one. Though, presently, or even the after when the lockdown started, we were taking the hard code also, and that may also continue for some time. But finally, we will ensure that no paper will be taken in NCLT. Okay. So this is a registration part. Who can register only, not a registration part. So for registration, how you have to register. And you will go there. I'll show the slide. Just one. You must be the screen is visible to you. So this is user login.
Chakshu, अगर वहाँ पे जरा थोड़ा enlarge कर दो इसका, ये side का column जो आ रहा है इसका delete कर दो.
ये मुझसे भी delete.
सर circle end से होगा सर, आप ये right arrow आपको दिख रहा होगा वो कर दीजिए click.
सर right arrow जहाँ पे convert to लिखा हुआ आ रहा है सर, उससे पहले एक arrow सा छोटा सा. थोड़ा सा राइट ना, राइट सर, राइट 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 राइट.
और इन द व्यू मेन्यू इट कैन बी एनलार्ज्ड.
टॉप पे 67.2% आप उसको फुल व्यू कर दीजिए
सर. थोड़ा सा नीचे से एडोब के नीचे ना. नहीं सर, नहीं 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 यार. छोटा सा कॉलम में बस ये इससे थोड़ा सा ऊपर. हाँ, ये अभी आया था सर. बस इसके हल्का सा नीचे सर, ये थोड़ा सा नीचे जो एरो आ रहा है
ये
थोड़ा सा. हाँ ये बस
ये वाला ना.
इसको हाँ, इसको क्लिक कर दीजिए सर, एरो को. इस एरो को क्लिक कर दीजिए सर, एरो को.
हाँ
बस हो गया. ठीक
अच्छा ओके. सो नाउ यू सी यूजर लॉगिन, एंटर द करेक्ट यूजर नेम एंड पासवर्ड. ओके देन click to login. So you will found your this now next slide. So then you will see the two pictures, NCLT and NCLT. Right now we are in NCLT. So NCLT, you go to the NCLT. Then you, this is the disclaimer. This is very important. The very important disclaimer. Disclaimer, if all are able to read it, please read it. What you know, summarily, I'll tell you that whatever you are filing, that will be taken as an affidavit. And if anything wrong goes, then you are liable to perjury case against you. So that is the disclaimer in fact. So now we are entering in that area where you file. Means whatever the information you give, that is the correct. So now next.
NCLT filing will also be possible through this portal only?
No sir, right now it is not. They are also trying. Whenever it will be okay, then it will be linked in this only. So So that is the reason, because the project is a combined basically. So now so this the application is for the IPC and company and the Companies Act and even the LLP also. So IBC case-wise detail. Case-wise detail means you have to tell that under which under which act you are filing. Okay. So and what kind of applications you can file, that's also you can see here. Company application, those simple CP or company application IB or other, say, now one thing, company application word is there and we are using also. Everybody we are using since beginning, means 16 onwards we are using. But let me clarify you one thing, that this company application word is not there in rules. And you must, some of you must be remembering, there is an order by the appellate tribunal where they specifically said that for the IBC matter, no company application should be used, it should be interlocutory application. So in fact, it is not only for the IBC, it is for the all interlocutory applications, IA should be there. Because in rules, there is no word like company application in our NCLT rules. So this is just for information. So interlocutory application, execution petition, transfer petition, and company appeal and installation appeal, these are the some of the applications we can just want to show that you can do that. Now next, and when you will see, so reference number you will get when you will you think that you will get the reference number. And reference number, case title, petition, in this form it will come. Now that was there. Now you have to go in the basic. There is a 3-4 areas. Basic details. So basic details we have to go. Basic details. I have to go this way only. So for example, filing. So first of all, when you have registered as a petitioner number one, petitioner one, you have to put there yes and petitioner. If there is more than one petition, then you have to visit it. You have to add your petition also. Respondent, you have to do that respondent also. So and this filing number, you will get it. Scrutiny, clear. That is just the thing. Icons when it will when you log in, that it will be clear that it will be clear or not. And the company registration, that also you will get it. So if it is pending, then status of pending will be seen. And this is this e-file cases that will be in your desktop also when you have filed. So now I'll go directly to the your appeal petition filing. Yes, here is the what details you have to fill up in the your application. User can enter multiple petition in the list by filing and submitting the form and again and again. Okay, a 16 digit number is generated that you are getting it. Okay, whatever you file, whether it is application, appeal, at least. In between, if you want to tell me, please tell me, because see, this presentation has been made. These are the slides where we used to do the live, in fact, and we have conducted at our NCLT Delhi so many conferences also. But unfortunately, the participation was very less. So in this, when you see this, Then I can explain, because these you know, and circle the ellipse all over there, then you have to read and what you have to do. Otherwise, if we can live also, we can do. that I'll enter this thing and you get the password, you get the OTP, everything. But now I can show you on this slide. So please see that. So these the details you have to fill up. And if it is by the slide is not clear, then go in the circle. What is it written? Okay. So when you complete all these things, then next user can you can again add a respondent, because respondent also you have to fill up. Now you see the practical one, we prepare the plant or the company petition. So first what is there? First A versus B. A may be A, B, C, D, A and others. So in our first page just now, what what I have shown you, that is the petitioner's page. So the petitioner can be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 or N number. Now petitioner only, he has to add the respondent also. So this page is of the respondent. So fill up the respondent page also. What details you need to fill up in that? First of all, selected the mode, whether it's company or other, what is your respondent? Huh? And company name, then obviously when the company acts, the company has to be there generally in the respondent. Generally respondent, because our jurisdiction is also decided on the basis of the respondent only. Where the your respondent is there in the ROC, where the ROC is located. So, and SIN number, company, if there's a company, SIN number is there. Then your authorized person or director or company, similarly the nationality of the, because now a cross border insolvency is also coming. So tomorrow this answer nationality question will also be there. Then you have to do that. Then city, district, because when you write the city and district, prediction will be decided. So these details you have to fill up. PAN number, email ID, now email ID. See, email ID of the respondent, petitioner is having. If petitioner is not having, then please go to the master data. You will get email ID or other details also, even the other so many details. I think PAN number may also be there on the master data. Mobile numbers of the authorized person of the company. Why all these details of respondent is required? I didn't explain you to the petition, because petition you know about your details, you fill up. But the respondent also you have to fill up. Reason, the moment when it will go before the bench, so tomorrow, today we are sending the physical notice or to service also, but tomorrow, even today also, we are sending a message that some case has been filed against. With the reference, some of you must be getting that yes, this case has been filed. So for that purpose, we need all the details of the respondent. So when you filled up, what you have done, you have registered yourself, then you have filled up your petitioner's column, then you have filled up respondent's column. Okay. So now, what do you do after that? When you have fill up it, then next, in case of representative, whatever you are the representative, then you have to fill up this also. Now who is the representative? Fill up to visit. Now you see here, the click to view list of representative. What you have, there is a list already, the registered people. Registered people list is there. When you click it, there will be some name. And just you have to click the name, that the details will automatically come. Okay. Only those representatives which are registered in the e-filing portal will be available in the drop down. That is there. That is what I told you. You got it now? Then when you want to see any representative, then you click the drop down, there will be list, but the list will be having only the details of the registered people only. Okay, so now you have fill up your body performance, petition, respondent, and then what is it? User needs to be upload the format document like appeal, etc. Now you have by this template, filling up this and following these encircle directions, you upload your documents, appeal, affidavit, whatever, huh? And now you see the this word attention. What is the mandatory points? Only PDF file can be uploaded. Even if it is scanned, then you have to do the PDF. Because generally annexes are scanned one. The plant portion is soft. It can be the soft, but the annexes are generally hard. And that needs to be scanned, and after the scanning, the PDF is to be that has to be converted to PDF. Okay, and file for uploading should be scanned on this particular scale 300 DPI. That is a must, because there is generally complaint that why I was trying to upload but it is not uploading. So why it is not only because size is more. So please try to scan your documents as per this direction, 300 DPI. And generally, today's generation is a technical savvy, and they know. If don't know, then please take the help of your IT assistant, IT professional. Number of pages in each uploaded file not be greater than 300 pages. So generally, in the hard we take the 200 only. Speed. If it is there, why it is there? Because size will be more than 100 MB, it will create problem. Then physical file submitted and online, that is a different issue. Right now, we are not even taking the physical file. So now, you understood that you have to scan on the 300 DPI and convert in PDF, then upload it. Uploading is complete. I am again repeating what you have done. You have registered yourself, you have filled up your the petitioner column, you have filled up your the respondents column, and then now you have uploaded. Now what do you do? In a hard one, what do you do? You prepare your plan, you prepare your petition, and you ask your clerk or anyone to go to the NCLT counter and submit it. Similarly, here what we have done, we have prepared it, we have filled it, and now we have uploaded also. So after uploading, what you have to do? Submit. Submit means what? Submit means not. So before submitting, we have given one facility to you. There is checklist. What checklist we are using, that you will also get. This is the checklist. So please check yourself, that what you have done or your petition is correct or not. If anybody, though this is a very, size of point is very less, so there is a 25 point checklist is there. So check yourself that your petition, what you have uploaded is according to that. And one thing, honestly, you assess yourself. Don't do that, are chalega, वो आगे वहां देख लेगा, वो व्हाट व्हाट वो देख लेगा, देन इट विल गो इन द स्क्रूटनी, देयर विल बी ऑब्जेक्शन. सो टू अवॉइड एनीथिंग, सो प्लीज गो थ्रू दिस चेकलिस्ट ऑनेस्टली एंड से इफ एनी एलिजिबल और समथिंग इज नॉट एलिजिबल, देन यू करेक्ट डू इट. एंड वन मोस्ट ऑफ द टाइम द पीपल यूज टू कंप्लेन इन अदर लैंग्वेज, यू सी द लैंग्वेज ऑफ द टेक्नोलॉजी इज इंग्लिश. So people, they come with them, say, in a script of the Gurmukhi or Hindi or any other language. And then when we see that you have to file in a translated copy, then they say, arre saab, toh wapas jana padega, mera Mumbai mein rehta hai, mera wahan rehta hai. That is not this correct thing. So please go through it. That point is also in this, that you have to file the translated copy. So when you have uploaded, you have ensured that yes, my document is as per this list checklist. So now we'll go further. So what is there? Then submit. The moment you submit, then what he will ask? Now it will show you that what you have done. Petitioner name, respondent, and everything is there. Ki bhai aapka to first page is tarah ka dikh raha hai. You have to see this thing. So Because still it is in your desk only. It has not gone. When it will go? Obviously, after paying the fee. So, but yes, before submitting this thing, you will see it. Okay. So then now next now, obviously the final point, payment of the fee. It will go to the NCLT side only after payment of the fee. So payment of the fee, there is two methods of the payment. One is the online, one is the offline. We have kept knowingly this offline method because sometimes Bharat Kosh, which is our portal, so Bharat Kosh creates the problem. It takes time also. So then in such situation, one can adopt the offline. But let me tell you, I want to make it clear, but try to make your payment to online only, and especially during this period, please don't make offline payment. What happened right now? When we opened, April, 22nd April onwards, when we saw number of applications filed to e-filing and payment was made offline. And when we checked it, many checks, because check detail is when you opt the offline method, it will ask you the check detail, the demand draft detail. So that was nearly to expect. So then we were forced to issue a notice that please submit your checks physically, and if it is expiring, then the new demand draft is to be submitted. So this is to be ensured. While feeding the demand draft detail, please check the date of the demand draft. It should not happen that within 3 months or three days or in a week that your demand draft will expire. It should have at least a minimum 15 days time while you are doing that, so it can be submitted to the bank, because this is our problem. And you can submit, fine. Your petition will also go inside, no problem. But later on, we'll ask you whether then your demand draft has been expired. So to avoid such things, this is it. So this is all about the filing. What the filing is there. So now, next payment mode, when you will use these details, I told you that online, the details, whatever the details you will be figuring here, or in offline, all these things, you can see the whatever the mode you will opt, debit card or credit card. And finally, you will get this receipt that you have paid this thing. For example, this is the one example, has been a testing sample is there, that including your this transaction ID and your NCLT transaction ID, this number, 17 digit number is also there, and bank transaction ID is also there. So this you have to you have to keep with you, and it will go with the this also. And so this is your e-filing portion is complete. Now what we do? We have to do, this is the demand draft detail only, and this is the offline receipt info. When you will pay the offline, so you will get this receipt. Okay. So this is the e-filing. Now I want to have some questions, because other e-filing, that is for the NCLT, for every scope is there, and other case management or DMS. Yes, what I can tell you for writing question, that when you are filing, you have the one registration number, you are managing your data also, because our DMS system, data management system, that that is managing your data also with the one ID. Say today you have started, and after 1 year, if you see online, not in your desk, then how many petitions you have filed, that is also available with us. So now you please, there are some questions.
Yes, sir, I have some questions.
Yeah, please.
And I'm reminded of one incident, sir. Around 20 years ago, when I was part of the program with the exchange officials on future and options, a question came that, sir, the presentation is over, but sir, ye bhai, option trading karenge kaise?
Mm-hmm.
So the reply came, the taste of the pudding is in eating.
Mm-hmm.
So unless you trade, you will not come to know. And the same is the case here. Sir, you have told everything in detail, but unless somebody files it, you will not be able to understand it completely. But I am really thankful to you that your user manual, this user manual which you are showing to us, is very, very helpful, very handy, very simple. However, I have got some questions I would like
to. And for that also, Madan sir, I will send you on the WhatsApp. Detailed presentation I will send you on WhatsApp on your personal thing. You can distribute everybody, no problem. There's no restriction.
We will do it, sir. Okay. Now, sir, the question which you have received it.
Yes.
That once we file the documents, who can have access to these documents?
Yes.
Can the filer or anybody else, or filer will also not be having any access?
See, he with his own ID, he can open this company petition. On petition.
Okay.
And I told you that even the if you have filed 10 petitions, that is also be available with you. But you cannot see others document. You cannot see the others document.
Okay.
For that purpose, we will after some time we'll put them kiosk for inspection.
Yeah.
Also, we will try to inspect, allow the inspection on the kiosk without physical, because we'll. Just apply and then you can see the file. But though it is a, it will take some time, but yes, that will be the facility.
Achha, next question is, can one apply online for a certified copy of the order?
See, right now we have not kept that, because that is a, the provision we have not made that.
Okay.
Clearly speaking, we have not made. But right now in COVID period, what we have done, if somebody, for example, free copy, if somebody requires, then he can request, then we will prepare it. And if somebody goes, then we are avoiding for physical visit. So we can scan it and we can send it. But one can take the color print out of that. You got my point. That one can for free copy. And
okay.
One can say, you can say that my this and such order is there, free copy is required.
Okay.
So what we'll do, we'll attest it, and we'll scan it. We'll scan it at our end and then send that email to him.
Oh, very good. I'm also going to be beneficiary of that, because during this period number of orders have been uploaded. But I must compliment you, during this COVID period the orders are being uploaded on the website within 24 hours or maximum 48 hours.
Are sir, raat ko 12 baje kiya yesterday ka kissa nahi pata aapko?
Nahi, I don't know.
Aapka gymkhana?
Okay.
Raat ko 12 baje 19 minute pe kiya raat ko. There was enormous pressure.
Okay, I can understand.
Ah.
Okay, sir. Is there any limit of payment of fee through e-payment mode?
No. See, when you will select the section, because in that template, that is the reason if practical, if you have it in front of us, then I could have explained everything. When you will put this, say, section 241, 242, automatically fee will be there. Exercise fee is already paid. The litigant is not required to calculate. It will come automatically. Yeah.
It will automatically. And automatically, irrespective of the amount, the fee can be paid online.
Yeah, online. Yes.
Whether multiple logins are possible with the same email ID or same mobile number?
No, sir. You have to register as one person. Say you have registered as IP, then another, because then otherwise he will message will be that this is already registered.
No, but now the question arises, somebody's IP as well as advocate.
Huh.
He is representing other clients also and representing himself also. So will you be having a, how should he register, either IP or advocate?
Advocate, he must register. And I think there is always two mobiles, no problem in that.
Not necessary, sir. Two mobiles and two email IDs also required.
And in fact, the problem is that the computer system will say that this, with this mobile and this ID, somebody is registered.
Yes, it will tell
that. Your technology, I can understand, you can understand. But technology say no, this is already registered.
Okay. If any document which has been filed, is it possible to modify that document or to replace that document?
Yes, for that, modify. See if as per the scrutiny list, your document is okay. You got my point?
Right.
As per the scrutiny, when your document will go to the registry will again scrutinize. If it is okay, then it will go, it will be the part of the court file.
Okay.
Then you, for modification, then you have to move an application.
Okay.
One thing, your proper application. Otherwise, if there is any defect, then your registry will send it to back. You can do.
Now you have filed an application before it gets listed. How
before
can it
get
modified?
Listed.
The application has to be made to registrar.
If it has not gone through.
Hmm.
If it has not gone through, then again now see, technical technology also force us to be, you know, transparent.
Hmm.
So once you have been given one number, and that number has to either the defect or the defect, you remove defect. If not remove defect, then it is rejected, or if there is no defect, then it will be listed. This
right.
is the option. This is the option. Now in between you are telling that no, I want to modify it.
Right.
So now modification, there is no, in the hands of the registrar or registry, that in between registered application already the you have the reference number, they can't give you. And this what you can say, you can ask the registry, then there may be some defect. Put that defect, I'll send it back, I'll file it again. That we can do. You got my point,
right? You just refer to reference number. And the question is, what is the difference between the reference number and diary number?
Reference number, this computer comprised reference number, this 16 digit reference number.
Right.
And it is not only for your reference, it's for us also. It gives so many things. Your district, your state, or all these things. Because while we, because government also wants reports from us that how many petitioner file from this district or this state. So only through that 16 digit number we can do that. And diary number, in fact, after this diary number, reference number, and diary number is different. Diary number is your just that particular application number, this thing only. You got my point, na?
So diary numbers are being given nowadays also?
No diary number. On that only we are, you know, we are by hand also, we are doing that only. If you have seen that on a stamp also, we are writing with pen these 17 these numbers only.
And nowadays there is a CA number or the MA number are also not being given.
No, we are giving there in the COVID period also. You will get automatically.
In one of the orders only was seen yesterday unnumbered application.
Then their enthalpy, Steno's problem. It can't be. Because see one thing, now I want to clear. Here when there is no leeway is given in the technology to anybody. Even today, agar abhi aapko kabhi time mile to aayega mere paas.
Sure, sir.
In COVID period, we have received more than 500 applications. 500 applications. And without a number, we can't, push it forward. That is mandatory in the computer. That is the reason computer takes the honest us. What happened? It might have been done in, by the steno. They just typed it. Can't happen that it will be listed. Yes, it can be. It might have been done. Yes, there is one thing. That particular application has not been filed through e-filing. Somebody might have emailed.
Okay.
Only email. On initially what happened, that we were also in the COVID period, we were also thinking that yes, where the individual goes, that we took the cognizance of the simple emails also. Though in our notice, specifically we stated that you please in these stations, e-filing is there, you file through e-file. If you have seen the notice, that is critically said that in five places, e-filing there, you file through the e-filing portal. Still some people, they just drop the email and they send this thing. So taking this, this situation, we might have listed it. So then the no number is there. So now this is, that problem is not only for you. That is for us also. We have to introduce that application in our system. Otherwise that will be not out. So that is the reason I request everybody, please file to e-filing only.
Okay.
Yes, please.
So next question is that only filing status shall be shown, or only the status of the case or order shall also be available on this portal?
No, orders is the website we are putting it. Huh?
So this portal is filing purpose only.
See, not a filing purpose. There is three modules of this. One is a case e-filing. Now next is a CIS, case information system. That is fully for the official purpose. How many cases has been filed, how many this thing by, for preparing the returns, government this thing. And third one is DMS. DMS is what? A data management system means when you file, when your petition will come to us, simultaneously it will go to the DMS. And that is the DMS only, when the number is given, when it will go to the court, will click some number and it will come to the court in front of the judge. Or even tomorrow we'll install the computers for you people also. If God will try and end up COVID period is over, then we'll put the PCs for the educates also. Yeah. So they can also see. Today, our president is not using any paper.
Okay.
To e-filing only, when the petition listed as per that clause list, he clicks, everything comes on his desk, and they are doing it. And even the other people also, for example, presently Mr. Tariq, he is in the COVID zone and something like that, red zone type. So he is operating from the home.
On Monday, Wednesday and Friday, 3 days a week, yeah.
So he is able to see the petition from his home only.
And I tell you, sir, during this period when the written submission, the brief written submission which are being uploaded on the WhatsApp, they are really helpful and members are taking advantage of that. They are going through those written submissions.
Obviously, this corona will teach so many things.
Yes. This corona also, many questions are there. When this corona period is going to be over for NCLT and when we are going to have the regular hearings?
Very good, though. This is a question is relevant, but answer certainly is not that thing, but yes, yesterday Delhi High Court has extended their normal business up to 5th July.
And even NCLT has also cancelled all their cases.
That is a specific case because some COVID case is there, so they suspended for 1 week.
Okay.
But what we are thinking then on 15th July is there, then we can also put this either 15 or maybe 20th, something like that. We will also issue the notice.
Okay.
But urgent hearings, I'll tell you, I'll make you aware also that there are two urgent applications we are discussing all kind of matters. Some mergers also being discussed. Let me tell you, yesterday only ministry has and 400 merger matters that you are also the witness that even the normal period merger matters were not given the priority and there were not disposed of in this quantity.
Yes.
So 400 matters in Delhi and Mumbai were disposed of during the lockdown.
And next question is on the notarization of the affidavit. Is it mandatory?
Now in COVID period, we are not insisting. You know that people are also aware. But yes, please,
some of the answers I know, but I want the answer from your side actually.
No, I understand. But when the hard file will be submitted, then please ensure that yes, it is there. Right now, because in country is in turmoil, and we can trust also that yes, the person is filing, that is filing the correct thing. If tomorrow, because of this thing, some litigation goes, then what is the problem then? Yes.
So next question, whether any ID proof is required for creating the user ID?
Yes, that is also there. In fact, either your Aadhaar card or your this is that drop down, that is there.
Okay. In case of defect in any application, whether the entire application is to be refiled or the only the defect particular that page or paper is to be...
No. This is online. So you have to that you have the save page number so and so is defective. So we'll send it back. Now, if you file the single page, we are not able to edit your file. You got my point?
Right, sir.
So you'll edit at your end, then you'll send, no problem.
Achha, once this number is generated of a professional, when he's going to refile any other application, the moment it comes this number, whether all the details will be in autofill mode or he had to refill all the details?
No. When you'll file, say, in particular case, when that reference number is there, everything will come?
Everything will come.
Yeah. Yes.
No, if he's filing some other case,
his
details are concerned, his details are in autofill mode or?
His details are already available, his ID number is there, ID is there. In fact, he has to open with his ID only.
Okay.
ID and password is there. So all details need not to file again and again.
Okay.
Yeah. It is like our, in the passport, we use open our account and then we do that. Similarly.
Okay. So the next question is whether the documents which are to be filed in e-filing mode should be in legal or A4?
See, and now even the Supreme Court also told the this thing. A4. So as far as e-file is there, size doesn't matter.
Okay.
But yes, one side is required because otherwise the problem is there.
Achha, when an insolvency professional is registering himself, should he register as IP or IRP or RP?
No, sir. RP and IRP are not the this thing. He is insolvency professional.
Okay.
IRP and RP, these are not the permanent identity. Yeah. One can be IRP, tomorrow he can be RP, that is, he should be registered IP, insolvency professional.
Now, an application has been filed earlier physically. Now, with respect to this application, some reports are to be filed now. Can they be filed electronically? Is that possible?
See, we have taken all the data on our system, even the files are physical, we have converted that metadata, what you can call, we have already filled the metadata. So when you will file the CP number, with that CP number, it will go with that.
Very good. After e-filing, whether physical copy is required to be filed? Forget about this COVID period and normal period.
See, when all stations will be connected through e-filing, and for some time, we'll try to convince our honorable members also that they should also be accredited. And let me tell you, this all credit will go to the corona, that now the members, no, forcefully they are doing this, otherwise they always need the hard file. So now they will, now because of this, in this period, they will be habitual. So habitual to see this virtual file only. So
and nobody wants to touch physical papers, physical files.
Exactly. So I hope that after say July or by 15th August, we will cover all the stations and we'll ask all the members also, please don't touch the files. And slowly, only one file, one original file. We will take, as you know, in the High Court, they are taking. One file they are also taking, na?
Right, agreed.
That will do. That is in our agenda.
It means our system is capable enough to take all that load and our e-system is...
No issue at all. See, I have already paid my money to the MTNL to increase the bandwidth. Today, at no station, more than 8 Mbps is not level. I think more than 10, everywhere is more than 10. So it is enough speed. No issue.
आजकल तो 100 Mbps चल रहा है सर, 10 से तो कुछ नहीं होगा।
नहीं, वो कुछ होता है, वो 8 और 10, वो 100 Mbps वाला, वो 8 मोबाइल वाला नहीं होता। कुछ जिसमें हम लोग रन करते हैं।
अच्छा, what is the procedure people are asking to file urgent application and to get it listed?
See, today I have already instructed that whatever applications filed, we will list. All the applications urgent. Because see, as a registry, I can tell you about this. We cannot decide that whether this is urgent or not. When advocate or the litigant has filed this is urgent, we have to list for the bench. Yesterday, one member sahab told me, "Arey, aap to sab ko list kar dete hain." Then I told him, "If it is not urgent, you please order that it is not urgent. I am not going to tell you that's not urgent." Because somebody has filed urgent, we cannot decide. The registry can't decide. So we will list all the applications before the bench.
So for this urgent application also filing fees required to be paid, the 1,000 rupees?
Sir, that is the system. In fact.
No, it's a query only, sir.
No, that is system. Yes.
Okay. Then one question has come whether section 252 applications are also treated as urgent or not. 252 appeals.
Appeals now, some people have filed in that also, in 252 matters which are pending. Some people have filed urgent application in that also. Saying that or some particular period, they are expiring something, they have stated some reason. And we have listed it also.
Okay.
And today, even after this last week, when we have started all the courts, so I think now we, in 252 also, they can move application.
Urgent application.
Right.
Is there any size of the file, maximum size to be uploaded?
I told you that. That should be scanned in a 300 DPI and one volume, some 100 MBV or something like that. One volume. Otherwise, full size is not doesn't matter. But at once, that is given enough. I think 100 MB at once you can take 300 MB, 100 MB, you can do that.
Achha, whether progress reports are also nowadays required to be e-filed? Or can they be filed physically?
Progress reported by IP.
IPs.
Everything has to be e-filed.
Resolution professional and liquidators both.
Everything has to be filed e-filed.
And the question is whether filing fee is required to be paid along with the progress report also. as it is not an application?
See, this is not application, certainly it's not application. Issue is, the practical issue is that, that simple report is there, then it will not be linked with that file. And it will not go to the court.
Okay.
And application for application, we are invariably listing before the court. Even I told, so this query is not from your side. Some members also told me, but this is my personal view, that if something, whether it is a report, a liquidated report, RD report, RLC report, IB report, IIT report, if it is simply goes and attached with the file, no problem. But if it is not, has been put up before the court, then what is the use of it?
One member is writing from Chandigarh, and Chandigarh, we never pay filing fee along with the progress report.
And if they don't do, then that report, that cognizance of that report should be taken by the bench. That is a legal issue.
Okay.
It is not mere filing. If you are filing, that is fine. But what, as per the legal, this thing, it says, whatever you file, that should be put up before the judge, and judge should take cognizance of that. That is the procedure. If something is, you know, annexed it and, attach it, then I don't think that is appropriate. And I think, in fact, it should be emphasized from the litigant side, IP side also. What my progress report I have filed, it should come in the order. In fact, this what I am pressing, it should be pressed by the IPs, that I have filed progress report. Now the cognizance of the report should be in the order sheet. It is not the just annexed.
Right.
Because of this fee, I am telling you, why IPs are worried about the fee? This is quite a resolution cost.
Sometimes IPs are not getting even their fees, even their filing fees is also they have to incur from their own pockets. That is the reality.
For that, our Honorable Sahu Sahib is responsible, not the NCL.
I agree.
He has to devise some mechanism. At least minimum fees should be given.
Yes, absolutely. You raise a pertinent question. Many people will agree with you.
Yeah.
Every IP will agree with you.
Yeah.
Whether the application and documents can be signed digitally?
It can be signed digitally. It can be signed digitally, but see, everybody can take a digital signature from the authorized agency. I think NIC is also giving it. And we are also, very soon we will also take this, because the members are now physically signing. And they are traveling, people are traveling. So, when authorized agency will give the digital signature, there is no issue.
Okay. One question is.
There is a stamp at a digital sign.
Next question is, a hard copy for merger to be sent to IT department, ROC department, or e-filing will complete this procedure?
Our e-filing system is for NCLT.
Right.
Everything comes to the NCLT, that should come in the e-filing. But if it has to go to the other people, other respondent, other your statistics department, I don't know whether they have the system or not. Income tax ka to Bhagwan hi malik hai, wo to digital ke baad mein bhi nahi dekhte, aap e-filing baat karte hain.
Next question is, if there is any difficulty in filing the e-application, is there any contact number during COVID and post-COVID?
See, during COVID and every time, there is number, our help desk is there. Or the help desk details is there.
Okay.
And our assistant registrar's number, I think too many people are having. Mr. Samander Shukla is there.
Okay.
And let me tell you, in this COVID period, you find me always good, but sometimes also got irritated, because at 8 o'clock and 9 o'clock at night, पीपल आर रिंगिंग कंपनी एंड आस्किंग सर मैंने एक ई फाइल किया है कल अर्जेंट एप्लीकेशन के लिए। तो मैंने कहा भाई मैं वहीं बैठ जाऊँ क्या, तुम्हारा ही एक डेस्क खोल लो यार, कम से कम रात में तो रुको। और वाई वी आर वी रिंगिंग अप माई पर्सनल मोबाइल, सो दो इन द ग्रेव प्रॉब्लम आई ऑल्सो टेक द कॉल नो प्रॉब्लम बट अपराइट पर्सन एंड दैट इज इन द डे टाइम आई रिक्वेस्ट एवरीबडी डू नॉट टू डिस्टर्ब एवरी टाइम because at least our staff is coming daily to report. You should pray for them.
The one thing I have observed during this COVID period, whenever the WhatsApp groups are being created for the particular cases, we are getting messages at night from their court staff at 11, 11.30 at night and morning at 7 a.m. also. Day and night.
So you can see that they are working. They are working. They are working. So, because the reason is that for one day, 10 cases are there. In one case, say, five advocates or maybe more than that. Then for each case, one group has to be formed.
Right.
And the link has to be given to them. Even after that, people ask, see, we all have to adopt the situation. That is there. Yes, please.
One thing is when NCLT Ahmedabad e-filing is going to start at Ahmedabad.
See, we have already given undertaken the training to the staff and even the litigants also, advocates also. So, 1st July, I am taking the date for the Kolkata. After that, I'll ask Chennai and then ask this
One person is writing, I'm trying to register myself as an advocate, but it is not allowing me to do that.
What he message is?
No, the question stops here only.
Then he can contact the help desk. I think he must be missing something, otherwise there is no denial. Or maybe site maybe you know that particular time maybe down something like that. Let me
know. I filed an IA, did the e-filing and paid the fees. I have not been allotted the IA number yet, at least not communicated to me. What can be done? I need the IA so that I can communicate it to the registry in Delhi so that it can be taken up on board at the earliest.
Definitely, and I don't know when he has filed, but it must be the process after he's ready. Definitely, you will get.
Okay. When and how does applicant get the petition number? Whether applicant get any message or he will have to continuously keep checking?
He will get the message. IA number also, petition number also, he will get the message. People are getting it.
I am registered as a practicing company secretary, but now I have come to change my profession to advocate. How can I change it on this e-portal?
Registered as an advocate?
Earlier you were practicing company secretary, now as an advocate.
So delete that.
But the mobile number and email ID remains the same.
So he can withdraw early registration. He can take it out. I think that there is some option.
Okay.
And if it is not there, then I'll check whether there is an option of the withdrawal.
Right. When we file the case on behalf of the client, are we the authorized representative and do our name appear in the drop-down list of AR?
If you are registered, then it will be already lifted. If you are registered, whether it is a company secretary, then your name is already there. In
How much time does it take to get back any query from registry after the application is filed?
It depends on the time and the amount of the application pending. It is not automatic. It has to be seen.
will the system follow FIFO method for listing the matters?
FIFO what?
First in, first out.
No, it is not like that, because sometimes one has filed today and one filed the 15 days back, but Scooby is not there. Scooby is still there. He has to modify it or remove the defect. It is like that. It is not that the first company, everybody, everything is being listed. You have to check everything. But generally, in COVID, in COVID period, definitely we get accumulated around 300 applications. And that is the reason we switch on all the 6 courts. So that this pendency will, it can be covered. Otherwise, in the normal course, first come, first serve hi hota hai. There is no discrepancy, at least in Delhi, there is nothing like that. The petition is complete in all respect and is not listed. It is not there.
What shall be treated as date of filing of the application? Is the date of online filing or date of physical filing later on?
No, date of online filing.
Date of online. Whether an application for a certified copy be filed as an interlocutory application?
Pardon?
Whether an application for a certified copy be filed as an IA?
For certified copy?
Yeah.
IA. See, if one has filed IA, no problem. Definitely we will comply that order also. But no need to file IA.
Okay, no need to file.
Because that is the reason yesterday I was telling you that there is a procedure of the this thing in the rules now of the regarding the certified copy inspection, etc. It is not that, it's not required to be one thing, just how you asked me that whether the date of filing is the filing or the hard copy. See, in this COVID period, we are taking the e-filing and we are listing it. Let's say tomorrow for some time, though I hope that after this all these things, we will start with this only. But if tomorrow the hard copy is required, then that should not be the enormous gap that one just filed and after say 1 month or so, he will file the hard copy. And that's a different issue. For limitation purpose, I think e-file, and today at least, e-filing is the date.
Matters which were kept for reserved for orders before lockdown, how to get the matter listed for pronouncement order on urgent basis? Whether an application is required to be filed or they shall be pronounced automatically?
But we have written all the members to pronounce these orders. Like if it's still pending, then in Delhi, if it is there or any other place, they can apprise, they can tell me also. I'll try to push the members that you please do that.
No, but whether
for reserve matters, application can be filed, but application, when the matter has been reserved, then if one can file, he is free to file, but I don't think there is a need. But if it is filed, then definitely. See, this question, I can't answer straight this question. Because this is pertaining.
This is not pertaining to filing also, rather.
And bench also. So
let me share my experience. During this week, two of my old reserved orders have been pronounced without filing any application.
That is the reason we are trying and we are telling the members that please do something. So that is there.
If any additional document is to be filed, then what is the procedure?
Additional, with an application, you can file any number of additional documents.
Okay.
No problem.
Can we amend online application in NCLT regarding change of IRP after his consent?
His consent. His form 2.
I think this is not a filing question. This is relating to bench. This is a legal question.
He wants to change the form too.
Yeah.
After his consent, then he has to make an application, proper application. Yes.
Can an advocate download the petition in which his client is not a party?
No.
No.
And it is you know, exercising the other's power.
Can I join a hearing as an audience?
Delhi High Court just now they told that we'll allow the audience also in the DC, and I'll see their mechanism how they will do. Because let me accept honestly, we don't have the much staff and as peripherals as the High Court has. And you know, High Court is having High Court. This Cisco fellow, I contacted him. Then what he told, sir, मैं कभी आ जाएंगे, बाकी तो मैं High Court में बैठता हूँ. Means he is ready to resolve the High Court problem, but for me he is available once in a while. So that is the problem. Because in that High Court guideline, what they have done, that the public who wants to see the proceeding, they have to tell the court master one day prior, means 9 p.m. Now the High Court has issued the order, but now High Court Chief Justice or the Registrar General, they did not appreciate the misery of the court master. That poor fellow will sit whole night for this purpose only.
Mm.
So let us see how the High Court will be success, and we can also think of something can be done.
The next question.
Or one thing, this Cisco can allow like Zoom.
Okay.
So because in Zoom, every link can be sent to 1,000 people,
cool,
and they can see that. But one problem is there, sir. Why we have seen even the 2-3 people also, the advocate, they speak in between. They don't stop even. If you will allow so many people, na, then proceeding has gone.
I've seen that because they don't mute themselves.
They don't mute. Even again and again we request, sir, please mute, but they don't mute.
Yes.
That is there.
The matters which were listed before the lockdown and still not listed, what about them? I think urgent application is to be filed.
We have given the date also. We have given the date. Now, what is there, what we can do? We are not shifting the date. Today, yes, in between we did not give the date. I think the first time we gave the date of the 3rd June, then later on 15th June. Now, how the COVID situation prevails, if it goes further, then we have to shift. We don't have any option.
Mm-hmm.
We have to, and we all have to bear this loss. And we can, we are trying to cover up to these urgent matters. Though I am sure that it cannot cover fully, but a bit relief is there. That's all.
And the way the situation is today, Delhi has crossed Mumbai.
Sir, it will cross. And you know, by this month only, I think 1 lakh will cross.
So there is one question, can we use one's username, login ID for filing the case across all NCLT benches in the country?
Yes, that is there. You can use.
Okay. Can an advocate, this question is over. I don't think we have other questions. Some of the questions are there, but they are legal in nature, not on filing.
If you can put one or two, then I can try to answer that also. But tell me one question out of that.
Okay. One question is very long, I think. Does the petition need hyperlinking?
No hyperlinking. Because hyperlinking, they will not scan any PDF. It should be filed in PDF, no hyperlinking. Hyperlinking is not allowed.
Can we apply for certified copies of the orders which were pronounced before COVID?
See, this is always open. They can apply. There's no this issue is that we have not opened the counter. Because if you open the counter physical, then you can imagine the rush on the counter, and it will be adverse to everybody. That is the reason.
Okay. What is the recourse available to get back the failed payments, as it is very common?
Failed payment means it has gone from the account and it has not been.
It means the payment has gone is not being reflected on the system.
And that.
And then the payment has been made to the second time.
One remedy is that if it is, the person is regularly practicing in that, then after sometimes he will get some or he can apply for the refund also. We can do that also, but it will take time.
Otherwise, also nowadays the NCLT is working in tandem with the Prime Minister Relief Fund.
No, we don't. We can't say that. We can't. Procedure is there to of the fund, but yes, it will take time. You know, when anything goes in Sarkari Khata, then take out from that is very difficult. But yes, it can come. It may take 6 months, but it can come.
Can we do submissions for the petitions which are already on the board and one or two hearings are already done before COVID? I don't know whether queries or not.
Why not? Why not? Is there additional affidavit time thing only?
Is there any maximum time limit during which the certified copy of the order can be applied or received?
This is your first come, first serve. No problem.
Okay.
There is no issue. See, only pending in case if the file is with the judge or something like that. Otherwise, there is no pendency in the certified copy. And if anybody is having problem, he can directly tell me what is the problem.
On which email ID of NCLT we should apply for certified copies?
Email ID, email ID, there is only one email ID, but email issue is again problem because only one email is there. That is the registrar's email.
Okay, so on that email ID only one should apply.
That is there. But without, I told you the free copy only, because a paid copy through email, it is the payment option is not there. So either one can come and apply after 4 o'clock, because we have for the limited purpose, we have opened the counter also for the checks, etc. Nah? So if somebody is in very dire necessity, then he can file there.
Whether filing fee is required to be paid on all the documents, whether it's an affidavit or progress report or any other additional document?
See, affidavit is to be filed for some purpose. Affidavit is not simple affidavit. How one is an affidavit? And for progress report, I told you this is the reason, technical reason. Otherwise, if somebody reports, then we will also put in the report only. That is there.
Some of the insolvency professionals are filing even minutes of COC meetings without progress report.
So they should file with an application. I told you the IPs, I don't know why they should file. Why they are filing? First of all, the purpose should be clear to them. Why they want to file the minutes or anything? Because they want to get recognized by the cognizance by the bench, and the bench cognizance can only be said once it is reflected in the order sheet. If it is not reflected in the order sheet, you can file 100 things. What is the use? Tomorrow when the final order, it is not only the let me tell you, it is not only the part of the IP only. Even I have seen in the final orders, in the, when the resolution proposal is cleared, so many things are left. It is not a complete one. I should not say, I am not entitled to comment, but yes, that is the fact is fact. So why it is not there? Because everything has not come in the order sheet.
Another question is, jurisdiction of NCLT bench has changed from one NCLT to another NCLT, say Mumbai to Cuttack in one matter. What will happen?
So they should file in Cuttack now.
I don't have any other question right now on the portal. If sir, if you have anything else to cover.
Okay, thank you very much. And certainly this presentation, I can say this is not encouraging. As you F&O case you told forward and option wala SEBI wala jo that is correct. Reason being, because if this is a, you see, there is 3-4 steps. One has to register as individual, as a firm, as this thing or IP or whatever. Then he has to fill up the petitioner's column. In petition column, all the details are there. And if you want to add the petition 1, 2, 3, and number of petitions he can add, and then respondent detail, he has to file 1, 2, 3, 4, or the respondents. Then upload. I don't get the 300 DPI and 100 MB file. This is required. When it is there, then he will see what he has done. Then payment mode will come. Payment mode, there's a 2-level payment mode, offline, online. If online is there, then the separate receipt is there, online, offline is there, and this another receipt he will get. So this is the filing, as far as filing is concerned, these are the only steps. I have covered, and I repeated so many times. It is not that I have not repeated. Again, I repeated it. If one will see it, he will come to know. And any problem, help desk is there, and again, same thing what you told, bhai practice karoge tabhi pata chalega why ya nahi aise to kaam nahi chalega hai na
ek question
ye hai ki abhi hum ye karenge ki july aur august 15 august maximum 15 august ke baad hum option chhodenge hi nahi ki aapko karna hi padega
very good
to fir apne aap sik jayenge.
That is what the question is, and you have responded that question already. Number of members are asking question when all the benches will go into e-filing mode. I think you said already by July end, all the benches will be e-filing mode. Yeah.
See, my point was, you know, when I went to Hyderabad in the February 3rd, I told that the then Secretary J.P. Srinivas that I will complete by June everything. But now, you know, God's message was something else. So everybody was, you know, lockdown and so still we have given training to the all professionals, not only our people. We have given the training to our professionals. So many people, I think today they are attending the webinar, they might have attended from the various places also. And I see people, they have given their training how to file.
Right.
Yeah.
Sir, I have one request to you that today we have covered e-filing.
Yes, please.
We have an event where you can cover, sir, NCLT rules. If you give consent, we can arrange for that event also.
And definitely, and I'll also like that everybody should be aware about the rules. We'll do that, no problem.
Okay, we are very shortly we'll communicate to you, sir, and so that you have given your consent. Thank you very much.
Sir. Okay.
So from my side, a very big thanks to you. I tell you, some of my queries have also been answered today, and I've got a clarification of a number of issues which were there in my mind. And though the members have also asked this question, so coupled with everything seems to have got cleared. And I tell you, sir, because there is no question at all at the end, it means almost everything is clear to all the 620 members right now. Earlier they were 850 members. Everything has been made clear to them. And still, I'll say that whenever there is any issue, they can always write to you. They can always.
Yes, definitely.
They will get a response. Thank you very much from my
side. Sir. Thank you, everyone. Thank you very much.
Over to ICSI IIP for their final comment.
Okay. Chakshu,
are you there? Chakshu?
सर थैंक यू यस
यस
सर
फाइनल कमेंट्स फ्रॉम योर साइड
टू या सर इट्स अ रियली वंडरफुल सेशन आई वुड लाइक टू थैंक श्री शिवराम बैरवा एज वेल फॉर द प्रोवाइडिंग इनपुट ऑन द ई फाइलिंग सो ऑल्दो वी हैव रिसीव अ गुड नंबर ऑफ द पार्टिसिपेंट्स एंड दे आर participating in doing the active participation like sharing their questions sharing their queries on the subject matter and thanks to you Madan sir for moderating so nicely with this event sir to shift sir so there is some participants who are requesting for the presentation so would it be available for them
sir has already committed he will send it to us and we will send to the participants
I'll send it
sure,
to
sir.
You
Thank you, sir. Thank you
so much, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you. Thank you.